Hi, this is John from PortableFreewareGames.com, and I'm not here to show you a game on the website. I'm here to show you something else. So if you click on your browser, and you type in PortableFreewareGames.com, I want you to choose the software option, and then scroll down to the bottom of that page, choose page 2. And then scroll down that page until you get to the ninth option, the ninth application. This is it here, Shortcut Video Editor. I want you to click on that wee image. And that'll take you to the download page, where you've got a video for the application, you've got a brief description of the application, and you've got a download button for the application. Let's download this. Save. And this is the file here that you'll download, shortcutvideoeditor.exe. It's an .exe file, it's an executable file, and like the games on PortableFreewareGames.com, this application does need to be installed to run. So let's double click this. And as you can see, it opens out into this nice menu here, where we've got the name of the website, presents, the name of the application, and you've got three buttons, you've got a readme button, you've got a PISA button, and you've got a run app button. Now starting from the left, the readme button is instructions for the application and copyright owners for the application. There's also a very handy wee link that I've added to that, and it's basically, it links to the application author's website, and they've got a lot of in-depth tutorials, so you can learn this application pretty quickly and get pretty good with it pretty quickly. I'm just going to show you the basics right now. But it's quite a handy wee piece of software, and it's quite versatile. You can do a lot of things with it, a lot of things that I'm not going to show you. So anyway, that's the readme button. And the PISA button is a paid internet survey app button. And it's basically a miniature mobile website that details the 25 best paying survey websites on the internet. Now there's 25 of them, and out of that 25, 5 are completely free to join. So there's no financial risk. And a further 10 offer a full 60-day money-back guarantee. So if you buy into it, if you pay for the subscription and you're not happy with how much money you earn after 60 days, you can just get your money back. It's a great wee thing. All you really need is an email address and some free time, and you can start earning some money off the internet. And last but not least is the Run App button that runs the app. Let's click this, run this app. And when you first start the application up, this is what you're going to see, almost a blank screen. Down the bottom of the screen, you've got some media control buttons, play, fast forward, remind, etc. And at the top of the screen, you've got a toolbar, a bunch of options, a bunch of things there for you to do. If you don't have this toolbar, go into View, Show Toolbar, and that'll show it up because you're going to need this. I should really start off by telling you two things. One, I am not an expert with this piece of software. Please don't email me asking for advice or help. If you're interested in learning more than what this video teaches you, there's a link in the readme option on the main application. There's a link in there that'll take you to the application author's website, and I've got a bunch of tutorial videos, starting from stuff for beginners all the way up to fairly advanced stuff. That's the first point I want to make. And the second point is, the way I do things is not necessarily the only way to do things for this application. Like all good pieces of software, there's different ways of doing the same thing, but I'm just going to show you my way. Okay, let's get started then. You want to click on Timeline, and that will create a timeline across the bottom of the screen. You want to click on Playlist, and that will give you a box in the top left-hand corner of the screen. This piece of software calls it a playlist. I would call it a clip bin, because that's where you're going to put all your media that you're going to use. And now we're ready to get started. Okay, let's add some media to this application. Click Open File, and you can browse to wherever your media files are. I've got mine on my desktop. This is on here, 1, 2, 3 and 4 are YouTube videos that I've downloaded just to mess around with, just to give me some media to play with. Number 5 here is a JPEG image that I'm also going to use. So just highlight the whole lot of them, and then open.
Fast food companies and other food processors drive down the cost of food relentlessly.
Some kind of lecture on food of some kind. I don't know. I have no idea what these video clips include, but we'll find that out as we move along. Open file. There's another file I want to add. It's the intro. That's the wee intro that I add to all my videos. If you've seen any of my videos at all, including this one, you would have seen that animation. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to left click it, drag it down to the bottom of the screen, and put it there. That's going to be the first video in my project I'm working on. Okay, now to start editing the YouTube videos, double click and click play.
Fast food companies and other food processors drive down the cost of food relentlessly and force economy.
Some kind of lecture on food, I don't know. And I'm just going to randomly click an endpoint. An endpoint is where your video clip begins. You can drag it to a random point there. And your exit point is here, or your end point sometimes it gets called. That's that there, that's about 30 seconds worth. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to drag this back onto my time, my playlist or my clip bin. Left click, drag. And that's onto there. Okay, and then I'm going to drag it down to my timeline. And that green part there means it hasn't joined up. So left click and drag it along till it meets up there. And that's my first video. It's actually my second if you include the intro video. But it's my first video clip that I've edited and added to the timeline. Now let's try something else. Let's double click this next video.
This is Coogan Cassius for IFL TV. We're in Simpsons Gym here. With me, I've got heavyweight boxer Anthony Joshua.
Okay, this is an interview with a boxer. What I'm going to do is, I quite like that wee animation at the beginning of the video, so I'm going to keep that. So my end point is going to be at zero. I'm not going to move that at all. But my end point, on the right-hand side, I'm going to drag it all the way over to about there. Now I'm going to drag this, now that I've cut that video down to size, I'm going to left click and drag it over to my clip bin. 2 MP4 duration, 17 seconds. And I'm going to drag it down with my timeline. Again, there's a green patch there. That means I haven't joined up. Now would be a good time to show you quite a cool wee feature that I found with this application. When you're putting your video clips down on the timeline, if they overlap at all, the open shortcut will automatically recognise it as a transition stage or phase, and I'll make the first video fade out and the second video fade in. Let me show you what I mean. I'll click on the timeline here.
Kind of play. Ship leads to a certain kind of aggregate.
You see what I mean? It fades in and it's quite cool. Quite a cool wee feature. Okay, here we go. MP4, number 3. Let's see what this video's all about.
Tower, this is Ghost Rider requesting a flyby.
Negative, Ghost Rider. The pattern is full.
No, ma'am. This is not a good idea. Sorry, Goose. But it's time to buzz the tower.
The tower flyby, and I have to say, I recognize that as a watershed event, so I stole that one right away because I knew that'd be kind of fun to watch later on.
Nobody in the...
This is a documentary about the film Top Gun. So let's just click 139, make a random selection. There's no method in the madness here. I'm just randomly selects in 30 seconds and 45 seconds or whatever, and that's me picked another video clip. Right click over to there, and now what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag it over to my playlist, and that becomes file number 8, MP4 number 3, and drag it onto the timeline. Again, there's a green patch there, and add it. Obviously, when you're doing this and you're making your own videos, you're going to be a lot more precise than what I am, because you're going to have a reason, you're going to have a topic for your video. This is just a tutorial video showing you how to edit videos, and I'm just randomly selecting different pieces of information. A couple of things that are quite handy is that once you've got a film in the clip bin or the playlist, it'll stay there. It doesn't replace itself with the edited version. That's quite handy if you want to make take certain clips, two or three clips out of one video, you can do that. The other thing is that when you're choosing your endpoints, your endpoint and your exit point, you can actually move it frame by frame using your arrow keys.
Ever buzzed the tower of Myanmar, so they all set up.
So you can get a lot more accurate, and that's about it. Let's add one more video clip, and we'll call it a day at that. I'll show you how to render it. So number 4, let's see what this video is all about.
Oh, the takes on Samsung AR emoji. Yeah, they ripped off the idea. Fuck, cheap fucks.
Taken on.
Isn't that funny?
Apple's like, always
Apple's
late.
Ripping people off. No, they were first with the iPhone. The iPhone was...
Okay, this is a Joe Rogan interview. Again, I'm just going to choose a random segment. That was one. That's my end point. And there's my end point. It'll be about there. I'm going to drag this over, and that turns into clip number 9. There it's there, MP4 4, number 9. Now I'm going to drag it onto my timeline, join it up. I think I'll make this one fade in and fade out as well. So that's them overlapping, and you can see it's made this X symbol. Now if you click on your timeline just before that, press play, just have a look at it.
And I noticed a lot of funny things, the cul-de-sacs, as I overflew them a couple of times to start to fill up with people. I had a buddy of mine that was living on base at the time.
Two operating systems competing side to side.
But that's how we are in our country. We can only Republican or Democrat, Apple.
And that's about it. That transition wasn't that good because it was two different people talking and overlapped each other. But if you're blending video clips together that don't have any audio, it's quite a handy, cool wee tool. Okay, now is the more important part, export, to complete it and get it ready for uploading or sharing. You click on the export button, and you got a bunch of options over here. On the far left, this is all your different options you've got. I've never heard of most of these options. But there's a good 70 or 80 different options there, and one of them is YouTube. So that's the one I'm going to select. It automatically makes it a YouTube friendly video. So click on YouTube, click export file. Where do you want to put it? Desktop. Give it a name, YouTube demo, and then save. And here we go, a wee progress bar in the top right hand corner. One of the good things about this application is that you can work away on stuff quite a thing, and you don't have to keep saving all the time. It'll save a copy of your finished product, but your project and work in progress doesn't necessarily need to be saved, which is a good thing, because it saves up time and it saves up the hard disk space. Here we go, we're at 20%. I'm just going to jump forward from here. and that says complete. So let's minimize this, shut down that, and look for YouTube demo. That's there, youtubedemo.mp4, 20.9 megabytes is well compressed. So let's just play it on VLC Media Player. There's my intro video that I put on everything.
Potatoes in Idaho won't venture outside into their fields for 5 days after they spray. And then when they harvest their potatoes, they have to put them in these atmosphere-controlled sheds the size of a football stadium because they're not edible for 6 weeks. They have to off-gas all the chemicals in them. So you see, the desire for a certain kind of chip leads to a certain kind of agriculture.
There's that transition. And that's about it. Let's get this back up again. Well, like I say, it's a very handy wee tool for video editing. Like all great pieces of software, it's fairly simple to pick up the basics, but there's more advanced options for more advanced users. But I like this piece of software. I've got it installed on my computer, actually. I use this. So I hope you download this. I hope you have a lot of fun making videos with this. I hope you have fun, and I hope you subscribe. Thanks for watching.